Today, December 12th, we celebrate the solemnity of Our Lady of Guadalupe, whose importance in Latin America countries in general, and in Mexico in particular, is undeniable. A devotion that provides hope, solidarity, and strength in response to the dramatic context of oppressions, confusion, and suffering caused by the conquest and the colony. A figure that managed to be equally significant for natives, Spanish, and Creole, and served as one of the most important symbols around which the Mexican identity was built. So much that it worked as banner in the struggle for the independence of my country. Under the shelter of the Guadalupana, a lot of Mexicans and Latin Americans have entrusted ourselves to her care. We have become stronger in our fights, and we have sympathized with those most in need because we have accepted the mystery of God in our lives. Indeed, precisely in the most important Mayan feast for my people, I want to underline the human aspect of Our Lady, because the relationship and the meaning that this has or can have in the experiences and expressions of Catholics. Thus, the reading of the Gospel reminds us of two fundamental facts in the Christian experience. First, God's initiative to reach our lives as it came to Mary more than 2,000 years ago. Second, the need for the human response to accept this offer to dwell among us. For this reason, the fiat of the Virgin is so significant that, despite the legitimate disturbance due to the weird message and recognizing that behind the words of the angel comes something until that moment unknown and confusing, she gives a sustained gesture that transformed her life and the history of humankind. Certainly, God loved us in such a way that He always searched for us, but not only as a proposal, as a respectful, constant invitation to receive from Him the life that He gives us with full hands. But indeed, that depends on our free will to materialize the transformation. Therefore, it is up to us and ourselves to accept the grace that comes from above and allow it to grow in our core and to be delivered to the whole of humanity, without distinction, exclusion, or petty favoritism, and preferably for those most in need for the conditions of oppressions, injustice, and suffering. Although the Father has already given us the salvation through the Son and the Holy Spirit, it needs to be fulfilled through the man and woman who recognizing in ourselves the wonders that God has done in our histories. We commit ourselves with the physical, social, economic, and cultural spaces into which we live, especially with the life and the future for the less favored. The experience of recognizing and accepting that the mystery of God lives among us is a source of joy, as affirmed by the reading of Zechariah, a joy that is necessarily communal and historical, that touches our lives, that humanizes our existence, that pushes us to be there for others without denying our own happiness. Joy, which we celebrate especially on this day in the manifestation of the Guadalupana in Latin lands, and that is present in us and in everyone who invokes and recognizes her as a loving mother who cares, protects, and inspires us. To avoid childish triumphalism, the revelation reading reminds us of the need to be always alert. Even though Christ overcame evil, this is always setting traps. With these disguises of success, power, and wealth, with the fear and uncertainty that it produces, with its important capacity for destruction, and with its eternal desire to prevent God's presence and project from being achieved in history. Evil that manifests itself in those excluded from the globalized world, in the victim of sexual abuse, in human trafficking, in those expelled from their countries because of war, insecurity, injustice, and lack of opportunities. But the Psalms also remind us that we are able to recognize when the mystery of God germinates and bears fruit in others. In them, we recognize the light they give us, the strength they give us, the hope they give us, and the certainty of God's action in history. Sisters and brothers, in this solemnity of Our Lady of Guadalupe, I invite you to allow, as the Virgin did, that the love of God germinates in each one of us, emerge in our relationships, give a strange and meaning in human history, and transform the culture of death to a full living space for everyone. Amen.